Hi, in this video, I'll be giving you an overview of Google Chrome's Devtools. This tool is essential for customizing Bootstrap's default styles. You don't need to install anything to use it because it automatically comes with Chrome. One way you can open Devtools is with a keyboard shortcut. Press the F12 key or Command-Option-I on a Mac. The other option is to right-click anywhere in the browser window and select Inspect. Once the Devtools panel is open, you have the option to orient the panel to the left, bottom, right, or separate window. To change the location, click the three vertical dots in the top right-hand corner and choose your desired location. Now let's look at the main sections of the panel to show you what you are looking at. The top section is the HTML of the page. The bottom section contains styles information and is split up into two columns. The bottom left-hand column shows all of the individual styles that are applied to the selected element. In the bottom right-hand column, there is this colored box that represents the CSS box model, which every block level element has. This box model has four main parts: the content, padding, border, and lastly margin. So you can use this chart to get a quick glance at what is being used by that element. If you scroll down, you see all of the computed styles, or all the individual rule sets shown in the left column combined. Instead of scrolling down the left-hand column and looking for the styles not crossed out, this section helps you quickly see what styles are applied to an element being inspected. In order to inspect an element, click on the Inspect Element icon in the top left-hand corner, the one that has a black arrow pointing in a square. Notice the different colors as you hover over the elements. These colors coincide with the CSS box model chart in the right-hand corner and help you quickly see if padding or margin is applied. With the tool selected, hover over elements in your browser window and click the element you would like to inspect. Okay, I want to see what the card title would look like if I made them red. In order to do this, I'm going to add a declaration to the existing Bootstrap card title class. Click the white space below the last declaration and write your new style in the input that appears. To apply it, press the Enter key on your keyboard. Next to the card title class, you'll see some gray text that says __card.scss:23. If you hover over this text, it will show you where the style originated from. Bootstrap 4 uses SAS source files, which are then converted to a minified CSS style sheet. This help text uses a source map to point us to the original location of the file. If I was compiling my own source code, I would update this SAS file. But in our case, we are linking to a minified version of Bootstrap, so I'll need to write a rule set with the same selector in my homepage.css file, so that it is also applied to this element. Another common task is adding CSS classes to HTML elements to test how things will look if the class is applied. Let's say you want to toggle the navbar dropdown from the DevTools panel instead of having to manually click the toggle button. The first thing you need to do is inspect the navbar so that you can see the navbar collapse markup. When you click the navbar toggle button, a class of show is added by Bootstrap's JavaScript. This class sets a collapse to display block, so it appears. In the styles tab, click on the CLS tab and type the class show and hit enter. You now have the ability to toggle the collapse visibility from the DevTools panel instead of clicking the button manually. Another way to add a class is to manually type in the class name in HTML. Just hover over the element and double click to edit the text. The nice thing about Bootstrap components is they are prefixed with unique names, so you can easily find scripts and styles for that specific component. DevTools has a search feature that lets you search all files for some text. Click on the three vertical dots in the top right corner and select Search All Files. A search step will appear. Enter in the text you would like to search for. In this example, I want to see all the styles and scripts for the navbar, so I type that in and hit enter. I want to take a closer look at the script in homepage.js. When I click on it, the Sources tab opens in the top section of the DevTools panel. Things are kind of crammed, so in order to open this in a new window, right-click on the homepage.js tab and select Open in a New Tab. And here is that script, so I can take a closer look at what it is doing. Another common task is updating HTML in the document. In this example, I will change this headline to see how it looks in the layout. I first inspect the element and double-click the text to enable editing. Then I write in my new headline. Okay, that works for small text changes, but what if you want to change a large box of code? In this example, I want to see what it could look like if I swap the UI design card with the strategy and planning card. In order to do this, in the HTML section of the DevTools panel, right-click on the parent element, in this case, the image card section. Now select Edit as HTML in the drop-down menu. Now select all the code and hit Ctrl-C or Command-C on the Mac to copy it to your clipboard. Now in your text editor, open a new file and paste in the code. Make your code window larger and specify HTML syntax highlighting to make it easier to read. Okay, I just need to cut and paste this code to swap these two column positions. Now select all the code and copy it to your clipboard again. Now back in Chrome DevTools, right-click on the section Edit as HTML. Now select all the text and hit Ctrl-V or Command-V in a Mac to paste in your revised code. The Enter key does not make the code take effect, so you have to click in another DevTools section. Once that is done, you should now see your revised layout in the browser window. In this example, I will show you how to test hover and focus state styles on elements. I want to see what it would look like if I change this button hover style to a light gray color. To do this, inspect the button by hovering over it and clicking on it. Next, in the bottom left corner of DevTools, click on the hover checkbox to show the hover styles. You should now see the hover style rule listed below. Let's change the colors to gray and black text. Uncheck the hover checkbox to test the result. Looks pretty good. You can follow the same technique with the focus state styles. All you need to do is inspect the form input and select the focus checkbox. Chrome DevTools also has a mobile device tester to help you see what your site will look like on popular devices. To open it, click on the icon of the smartphone in the top left corner next to the Inspect icon. To maximize the space of the preview, I suggest changing the dock to a new window. With the panel open, click on the device dropdown and select the desired device to test. There is also a responsive option that lets you drag and scale the width manually. I find this extremely helpful when testing really wide monitors. You will often find style issues at the extreme breakpoints, like extra small and extra large. For example, if you have a fluid width image, it can get really tall on wide monitors. So this tool is helpful in testing wide monitors without having to own one yourself. There are some pretty cool features in the options dropdown that can be found if you click the vertical three dots in the top right-hand corner. Let's say you are working on a client presentation and need some screenshots of your design. Chrome makes this really easy, and even has the ability to save screenshots with the device frame added. Yep. No more Photoshop mockups. In the options dropdown, click the Show Device Frame. When you are ready to save your screenshot, click on Capture Screenshot in the same menu. Now you can add it to your presentation or email it. If you purchased a Pro package, I included Robin, a responsive breakpoint preview tool. This tool is what I use to get a quick glance at multiple breakpoints at once. All you have to do is run it on your local testing server and enter a URL. By default, it loads the Bootstrap 4 breakpoints, but you can select other devices or add your own if you would like. If you zoom out in your browser window, you can show multiple breakpoints at once. After you make a code change, click the refresh button in the top right of the toolbar, or simply hit F5 or Command R on a Mac. So far we have covered mostly CSS, but DevTools also caters to JavaScript developers with tons of tools for debugging. The console tab is a great way for you to get feedback as you test your scripts in the browser. If there's a script error, it will display an error message in the console so you know where to look in your code. Also, instead of using JavaScript alerts, you can use console.log to write a message in the console. In this example, I have three console.log messages, in each of my JavaScript files. This lets me know if they are referenced properly in my index.html, and also that they are loading in the proper order. In this case, document ready, window load, and deferred. Breaking up your scripts by priority like this helps to load your page quicker. You can also run scripts inside the console to test selectors before you add them to your actual code. When working with Bootstrap, you will sometimes need to override certain style declarations. If you are compiling your own version of Bootstrap with SAS, you can change the styles pretty easily in the variables. But when you are linking the minified version, you need to use the Devtools inspect tool a lot to find the classes and styles you need to override. In this example, I'm going to remove the border transition style applied to form inputs on text areas with the form control class. You'll notice a border fades in on focus and fades out when not in focus. Since I have used the minified version of Bootstrap, the only way I can remove this style is to set the declarations to the default value, canceling them out. In the Bootstrap 4 Quick Start files, I included a PDF reference of the default CSS values to help you reset styles like this. I also have an online version where you can search for the CSS property. Go to bootstrapcreative.com/resources and scroll down and click on the CSS reference PDF link. I'm going to search for transition to find the default value. Okay, it's none. Back in my project, I'm going to add a CSS rule set in my homepage.css with transition none. I'm also going to add one for the WebKit version prefix, and then save. Now, when I refresh Chrome, I should see my override removing the transition. And if you look in the Styles tab in DevTools, you'll see our new style rule set. And if you scroll down, you'll see the transition declarations in bootstrap.css are crossed out, meaning the styles have been overridden by our new style. We covered a lot in this video, but there's a lot more DevTools can do, especially when it comes to script debugging and optimizing for page load. Below this video, I provided some links to additional sources of information and tips.